Hello guys, so in this video we're going to go over one of the tools for Unity that we at Epix VR find indispensable for mobile development, and that tool is the Unity Remote App. So what is a Unity Remote App and what is it useful for? If you've ever developed any applications for a mobile platform, you know the development process can be very slow and frustrating because you're developing on one platform and then deploying to another. So anytime you make a change, whether to your code or art assets, your whole project needs to be rebuilt, packaged, compressed, and then redeployed to your testing device before you can see any changes. On a typical day, you'll be doing this tens or hundreds of times, so this can obviously add a lot of friction to the development process, which can discourage you from taking an iterative approach to development and encourage you to do more monolithic changes. And that in turn is going to lead to more debugging time and more friction. So to get around this, one of the first things we can use is use an emulator that runs inside our development machine to make the process faster. In Unity, you can do that with the Visual Studio's Android emulator on Windows, but you can't do that for Mac, so you can only do it for one platform. This is where Unity Remote comes in. So the way that Unity Remote works is that instead of you having to build your project every single time you make a change and wait for it until it deploys on your testing device, Unity sends a picture frame by frame of your game or application to the target device so that you don't need to compile anything. You can see your game running instantaneously. And on top of that, Unity will read any input on the device, such as gestures or button taps or anything like that, and send it back to your development machine. So you get an app that shows you your game running, and then you can also use any input mechanisms that you've registered to see how your game is going to play out. Let's download a sample application from Unity and run it with the Unity Remote App to see what this looks like. So the first thing we need to do is download the app to our phone, and you can find the links for the Google Play and iTunes application in the video description. So once you have that installed, just run it and make sure that it's running correctly. It's going to give you a message saying connect this device with a USB cable to your computer and press play in the Unity editor to test. So there's two ways you can connect to your computer, either by USB or by being on the same Wi-Fi network. But obviously, if you can use USB, that's a much faster and more stable connection. So I've made a Unity project. It's an empty project. And inside that, I've installed the Tower Defense template from the Unity Assets Store. It's basically a demo game, a demo template that you can use, and it's mobile optimized. So you can go through the tutorials and see how it works, and at the same time you can run it using the Unity Remote App to see how it works on your device. So once you have that installed, we're going to go to Scenes and Main Menu, and this is the main scene that we're going to run. If we run our Unity Remote App and run the main scene, we're not gonna see anything at the beginning, and that's because we still need to do some configuration in the editor. So let's go to Edit, Project Settings, Editor. And this is what the message says. So over here we have a bunch of settings specifically for the Unity Remote App. First one is device, so we can choose between an Android, iOS device, or a specific device. So you can only test on one device at a time, but you can have two phones connected, one Android, one iOS. So since we're testing on iOS, let's choose any iOS device. And then next we can choose a compression algorithm. There's JPEG and PNG. JPEG is lossy compression, so it's going to be faster, but the quality is going to degrade. Since we're on USB cable, we can choose the higher one, the lossless PNG compression algorithm, and it will run fine. The next one is resolution. So the resolution can be downsized in order to make the compression run faster, because Remember, the thing that Unity Remote does is basically take a picture, a screenshot of your game, every single frame, and send it over USB in order to simulate running the game. So we don't want our, if we can get our resolution to run at normal without any frame rate hiccups, then we should go for the highest resolution possible. And finally, we have the joystick source, which is the input source. We can either use our phone for the input source, so we can use our tap and gestures on the phone to simulate input, or we can use our local computer. So if we're developing for a mobile application, presumably our input has been optimized for mobile, so we can go with remote. So that's it for Unity Remote settings. So now we can go ahead and hit play, and this time we're going to see the game run on our phone. So if you hold your phone in portrait mode, then the resolution is going to look weird, so it's better to hold it in landscape. And then after that, we can just go ahead and test it. And now we're ready to start the first wave. Okay, so as you can see, the frame rate is a little bit slow. The thing that you need to remember, and this is mentioned in the documentation, that using the Unity Remote app is not an accurate representation of your real game. It's not going to reflect how the performance happens on the device, because the game is actually being played and processed on your computer's CPU, not on the device itself. The device is just a view into your game. So you always need to run from time to time on your actual device and make sure that everything is running correctly. So that is basically it for the Unity Remote app. If you have any questions or any difficulties, any comments, please leave these below. And thank you for watching. Last but not least, we have an important announcement to make, which is that we're going to be attending GDC in March. So if you are going, then make sure to drop by and come talk to us. Check out some of the projects that we're working on, which we're going to be demoing. We are going to be at booth PL4302.